Convergent Evolution.
What is convergent evolution? Convergent evolution occurs when organisms who are not related evolve similar morphological traits, usually as an adaptation to a similar ecological niche. For example, the evolution of flight or the ability to swim. We will explore examples of convergent evolution and consider the wider implications of this evolutionary phenomenon. Convergent evolution can be witnessed in an animal we are all familiar with, the dolphin. Dolphins are cetaceans, like whales and porpoises. They share a common ancestor, Pachycetus. Pachycetus may have resembled a hippo, approximately 50 to 60 million years ago. As it evolved to suit its new marine environment, it gradually assumed a more streamlined and fish-like body form. As these changes occurred, it became no longer possible for these animals to return and walk on land. Their destiny was tied to the sea. About 200 million years before the evolution of whales and dolphins, at the beginning of the Mesozoic era, a group of opportunistic reptiles evolved the ability to swim and inhabit marine environments. One group, the ichthyosaurs, became so perfectly adapted for swimming, they developed fish-like bodies which looked remarkably like that of the modern-day dolphin. Like dolphins today, ichthyosaurs retained lungs for breathing air, lived on a diet of fish, and were also unable to move about on land. Unlike most reptiles, ichthyosaurs evolved the ability to give birth to live young in the water. Despite being so similar in appearance as a result of convergent evolution, ichthyosaurs and dolphins never actually lived together on Earth. Ichthyosaurs became extinct around 90 million years ago. So why did these animals evolve to a marine habitat? At the time that these animals appeared in the oceans, there was an abundant food source and far less predation than on land. The evolution of flippers and streamlined bodies meant they could move through the water with ease, using less energy than required on land. Research suggests that the Permian-Triassic extinction may have created a niche for ichthyosaurs, as they seem to have evolved rapidly after this event. In a similar way, for dolphins, the Cretaceous-Paleogene mass extinction may have played a part in their success, as it eliminated all large marine reptiles. Let's look to the prehistoric skies of the Jurassic and Cretaceous. Pterosaurs were a flying reptile, the largest vertebrate to ever have flown. They existed from the Jurassic through to the Cretaceous. Bats are the only mammal to ever evolve true powered flight. Bats first appeared about 55 million years ago. They, like pterosaurs, have a variety of body shapes and sizes. Despite existing at different times, both evolved similar traits which allowed them to fly, including a wing membrane that is stretched between limb and body. They both independently developed lighter skeletons to aid in flight, and coatings of pycnofibers and hair or fur for insulation. These creatures both evolved to fill a previously empty ecological niche, the sky. This made it easier to avoid predation and forage for food. Now, let's go down under to discuss a very interesting marsupial following the separation of the Australian continent from the Antarctic. During the breakup of the much larger Gondwanan supercontinent, marsupials were geographically isolated in Australia. This helped to drive further evolutionary change and innovation. One such marsupial innovator was the thylacine, or Tasmanian wolf. This animal evolved from a group of carnivorous marsupials about 15 million years ago. The thylacine, which was roughly 1 meter in length and 60 centimeters in height, hunted and lived in packs and was remarkably wolf-like in its appearances. It was sandy brown with several distinct dark stripes across its back. Sadly, thylacine went extinct in 1936. Following settlement of Europeans in the 19th century. Although wolves and the Tasmanian wolf have similar appearances, they are quite different. Wolves are placental mammals, belonging in the order Canidae. In contrast, the thylacine was a marsupial and belonged to a completely different order, Dasyeromorphia.
Despite its distinctive appearance, the thylacine was much more closely related to kangaroos and koalas than it was to dogs or wolves. Wolf-like canids appeared approximately 2 to 3 million years ago, but their early ancestors can be traced back to about 40 million years ago. Wolf-like canids appeared approximately 2 to 3 million years ago. The anatomy of these animals showed that both evolved sharp teeth to suit their predatorial lifestyles. The thylacine had 46 teeth, whereas wolves have 42, including specialized carnassial teeth which are used to tear and slice through meat. What about the future of convergent evolution? Past evidence of convergent evolution may help us to predict occurrences of convergent evolution in the future. Don't forget to like, follow, and subscribe to the History of Life channel on YouTube.